Hey everybody, how's it? Aloha, this is Jeebs. Good morning. I'm your old composer here, decomposing and tearing back the layers of your favorite tracks. In this case, of course, my head wasn't that buried that I've never heard of Nirvana, and of course I've heard some of their bigger hits. And I do recall this song off the album, but I didn't hear this unplugged. I had a lot of people say, dude, you've had this channel for over a year, you've never done any Nirvana, what's the deal? I don't know. I've done Alice in Chains and Soundgarden and Audiophile and Stone Temple Pilots and a lot of grunge. Grunge to me was, for me, I really enjoyed that period in rock. Short-lived genre, but you know, there was something about it that just spoke out to me. But anyhow, that being said, this is my very first Nirvana track, and it's all apologies, and it is the MTV Unplugged. I want to thank you guys, like usual, for hanging out, for your support, be it buy a cup of coffee, hanging on a Patreon, buying a little merch, sharing the video is important, commenting on the video is really important, especially this one for me, because I think there's a really serious position in a lot of people's soundtrack of life that this song represented. And of course, you know, the tragic story of Cobain, you know, taking his own life and stuff and the whole stress of it. I just don't know why I haven't gotten around to a Nirvana, but here I am. I say no more about that. This is my first Nirvana check here on the channel. So here we go. Nirvana, all apologies. All right. I didn't want to stop, but I obviously want to say a couple things. I emotionally am pulled in. You know, the thing is about an unplugged performance, even in the most heaviest bands, is it pulls you into the intimacy and, as far as I'm concerned, the heart and soul of the song, the lyrics, the melody. A lot of times in heavier production and stuff like that, the melody, though memorable, sometimes gets obscured by, you know, intense arrangements and performances and stuff, whereas an unplugged version of any song will really just cut through to the point and really kind of dictate, is this a great song? Is this a good song? Is this a powerful song? Is this a memorable song? And without a doubt, this is. His performance on this is wrenched in here. I heard that this song, though, had to do with getting married or something of that nature. I don't know. You guys, comments, please. You would know a lot more than I do. But you could just hear the angst in his voice and his performance. And what I love about it is that what a great melody. I remember Nirvana as being this just like mind-numbing change in music in a time period where it was like maybe it was getting a little, you know, stale from the 80s and crossing over, and it just kept on going until this movement came. And I don't know, I'm not a musicologist or an ethnomusicologist or a music historian and stuff. I only learn while I'm on this channel and some other people's channels I listen to. But as simple and as cool as that, that is being played in that pattern, it holds so much weight and so much support to this really super great melody and his performance ability, without a doubt. I love the cello. I don't know if the cello is in every one of these performances or the cello was just put on just for this song, because I didn't watch the whole, and this is the only unplugged thing that I've seen. And then it's nice to see the young Dave Grohl, you know, playing with the bundled sticks, very soft kind of a thing. But you can see he's just the mild Dave Grohl before he became the Dave Grohl of today. But I'm not going to talk anymore until after this video, because I want to get into it again, because it already had me, and I'm just pulled in just by, like I said, the intimacy of his performance and the fact that the camera's in your face on unplugged performances. You could see facial expressions and stuff. I think the one I just saw with, I think was it Lane that I just did, where you could see as he's performing, you know, and his eyes are rolling back into his head and what he's going through as he's making this performance. That's what I love about these unplugs. It strips away all of the production, all of the glam of musicianship, and gets right down to the song, you know, and that to me is what's powerful. All right, let me go back a little bit. Here we go. Everything is my fault. No idea until I heard this, that very last note that he hit. Oh, da, 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 da. All in, oh, da, 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 da. That was really cool. I don't know if that was there for the other ones, but how that was ended, that decrescendo of the music, pulling back on the music, or, you know, they slowly fade out until it was just him and Dave doing the harmonies. That was a great harmony, too. Subtle, but kind of a jabby harmony and stuff. I love what the cello didn't do. The cello did not do any solos and didn't really step outside of the arrangements that it had already established. And let's face it, that riff, that acoustic riff that is being played, was through the whole song, and it completely seduced me as far as into the hook. Just kind of kept me playing through. But going back into how watching him and how he performs it and stuff like that, almost as if he would give the same exact energy with a dialed up performance if he had the complete band you know, up there with all amps on 11. You know, even when he hits those notes where Barry, da, 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 he really had it in here. It was tight through here. He was pumped through, and he was pushing through it, and you can really feel it. the grunge era. I'm thinking back to myself. Plaid shirts. Was it the plaid shirts or something? And also like a, with the hoodies and stuff. And Ugg boots and jeans. That was me. Anyhow, I hope you dug this. I had a fun time listening to it. Thank you so much for just getting on me and the fact that I've never done a Nirvana. And I promise, excuse me, it won't be the last one. All right, guys, take care of yourself. Have a killer week. Aloha.